Hello, my name is Ramessa Ahmed, and I have the absolute honor of opening our graduation as this year's salutatorian. Truthfully, I'm not above milestones like these. And growing up on coming-of-age movies, I don't think any of us really are. We've all dreamt about this last year of high school in one way or another, especially this graduation, with all its quirky anecdotes and sitting through well over 500 names. Now that we're here, though, it feels a little empty and a little heavy all at once. It's funny because 5 years ago I attended my sister's graduation and I've wanted to give a speech like this ever since. So this speech has grown and evolved as we have throughout high school. Yet I always imagined that it would have this one final message of things get better. Because that was what I, and I think a lot of us, believe that this life was. The future and the hope within it. Standing here now though, giving this speech to a few people, a few teachers, and a camera, I don't think it would be fair for me to say that. And I don't think it would be fair for me to make this graduation about that. Because I don't know if it gets better. I don't know where that light at the end of the tunnel is, and I don't know if tomorrow holds a utopia or an apocalypse. Here's the wild, wild thing, though. Who cares about tomorrow? As Homer said in the Iliad, the gods envy us. They envy us because we are mortal, because any day might be our last. You will never be lovelier than you are now. We will never be here again. We will never be here again. High school is over, my friends. You will never again walk through that Massey crowded front rotunda with a day at Massey ahead of you. And whether that thought relieves or terrifies you says a lot about your experience over the past 4 years. But however that experience was, it's the very experience that's led you to this moment. And this is it, right here, right now. This was your life for the past 4 years. And you can choose to discard it as a rough copy or prototype for the life you actually want, or you can choose to honor it. You can choose to honor the person that stayed up late to finish assignments and the next morning just barely made it to class. You can choose to honor all the people you've loved and continue to love. From those that drove you to school in the morning to those that willingly gave you their calf fries. You can honor all the people that have helped build you into the person you are right now. And that includes yourself. You can choose to honor high school in its entirety, in all its glory and infamy, and recognize that your life is not just a highlight reel of just the good parts or just the bad parts. It's an amalgamation of everything you are and everything you experience. Honor it for no other reason than the fact that after this, it'll all just be a memory. So I ask you for the next hour to forget about tomorrow and all its fear and excitement, and just listen and watch the end credits of your high school journey. To experience the life you've built for yourself today, not the one that might exist. Tomorrow or tonight, when you're going to bed, think of the life ahead of you. Maybe then. But right now you are here. So just be here. Just be alive. Think of how far you've come and take pride in this moment. Honestly, I'd like to formally apologize to any of you I've ever shoved in the hallways, because while I was completely valid on my part, words cannot describe how proud I am to be graduating with people like you. So without further ado, congratulations, my friends and fellow Mustangs, and a very warm welcome to your graduation.
We acknowledge that we are on land and surrounded by water, originally inhabited by Indigenous peoples who have traveled this area since time immemorial. This territory is within lands honored by the Wampum Treaties, agreements between the Anishinaabe, Haudenosaunee, Lenni Lenape, and allied nations to peacefully share and care for the resources around the Great Lakes. Specifically, we would like to acknowledge the presence of the Three Fires Confederacy, Ojibwe, Odawa, Potawatomi, and Huron-Wendat peoples. We are dedicated to honoring Indigenous history and culture while remaining committed to moving forward respectfully with all First Nations, Inuit, and Métis.
With glowing hope. graduates and families. When we hear words like resilience, or grit, or adaptability, it's sometimes difficult to picture what those look like in action. When we speak of preparing our graduates for their leap beyond more than a decade in public education, it can be hard for us to articulate what we expect that to produce. This graduating class is the definition of those things. This achievement was earned not just in this year. What this graduating year presented was the gauntlet of challenges that tested what you've built along the way. With the support of your many teachers, your principals and vice principals, your families, your peers, you, graduates, have earned the reward of not only a diploma, but of the kinds of values, determination, skills, and drive that will propel you onto your next path. You've learned to advocate for yourselves, to speak up for what's right, and to maneuver through unexpected changes. And yes, you've even learned to take online tests. Whatever challenges you endured alongside your support system, you still showed up for yourself. What you'll do now with the embedded knowledge of experiences beyond your years will frankly be inspiring to witness. Your proms and sports rivalries and grad trips got replaced with history being written about what exceptional humans our 2021 graduates are. I'm sure that sitting at home watching this feels like a lame substitute for that see a selfie you were gonna take on your way out the front doors. I get it. Take a second. Look around you. Where you started in junior kindergarten, that little kid, they're in awe of you. Look around at your support system, of those people and relationships in your life that cheered for you, that taught you the knowledge you carry now, that maybe spoke tough words you needed to hear, and that guided you through all that it took to become a proud graduate today. And on behalf of the Board of Trustees for the Greater Essex County District School Board, allow me to humbly offer our sincerest congratulations to you, our gratitude to your support system, and our best wishes for the path you choose to explore next. May you be well, may you be safe, may you continue to be resilient in all of your paths. May you enjoy your summer break, and may you go forward with pride in your achievements. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Graduates, families, friends, and staff, we have endured another remarkable, exceptional, incredible year. Thank you, class of 2021, for your perseverance. You made it. You made it. One thing that has been accentuated during this pandemic is the isolation that has been forced upon us, increasing our need for independence, for self-reliance. A great deal of responsibility for your own education has been thrust upon you, but your teachers agree that you have successfully completed the requirements to earn your Ontario Secondary School diploma. Congratulations. We all have a renewed appreciation for what high school means to us. Previous graduating classes were part of a much more structured community with consistent traditions, practices, and expectations. But that bubble was burst by cold reality. Your determination to succeed, however, has made you better prepared for, maybe even immune to, drastic change. You are ready for anything. Maybe one of the changes that you've experienced is the new perspective on your future. The pandemic may have altered your personal or professional goals. It's possible your experience has guided you on a different pathway toward medicine, scientific research, the skilled trades, computer technology, maybe even education. It's probable that what you've been through and how the world has changed will inspire you to find new and better ways to do things. I urge you to follow those instincts. You are ready in part because of your newfound educational independence. Run with it. Demonstrate to everyone that we have not fallen behind. Staring down adversity may have actually pushed us ahead since we have changed in so many positive ways. On behalf of the Greater Essex County District School Board, I applaud your achievement. Again, congratulations, and I look forward to seeing all the great things you will do to change the world.
I want to welcome all parents, guardians, staff, and guests who are watching out there, but most importantly, I want to welcome our graduates, our class of 2021, to this commencement. We are so pleased and privileged to recognize your commencement in this online ceremony. One of the things we've learned in the last year is how important it is to seize every opportunity to celebrate your accomplishments and your achievements whenever possible. And today, we do exactly that. We know that the final chapter of your high school career was not how you had imagined it would be. Instead, you found yourself in the middle of a pandemic that cost so many so much. We applaud you. We applaud your strength and your perseverance, which will stand you in good stead as we move beyond this crisis. It seemed like there were consequential decisions that are needed to be made every day for the last 15 months. And there have been moments of doubt and anxiety, and there have been great challenges along the way. But through these challenges, we have seen our community come together, innovate, adjust, and adapt. In the last year, we have seen the very best of our students and staff. You have earned our congratulations and our admiration. You have worked hard, you have learned well, and you are ready to make your mark in the world. I urge you to be informed and active participants in the democratic process so that you can help your generation in solving the incredible challenges which face our country and our world in the 21st century. Indeed, in my view, the world desperately needs your generation to help overcome these challenges which other generations have not solved, including how to live up to our promise of equality and opportunity, how to save our air and indeed our planet for your children and grandchildren. We have already lived through great turmoil. Through your education, your innate abilities, and your hard-earned accomplishments, we know you are prepared to meet the challenges of tomorrow and to help us through the challenges we still face today. Wish each of you the perspective to forgive yourself and to learn from your inevitable mistakes, because mistakes are inevitable. I wish you the tenacity, the courage, and the good fortune to someday find a life's work about which you feel passionate rather than just settling for one which neither challenges nor fulfills you. I wish you the very special sense of satisfaction and self-worth that I have found comes only from using your talents and energy to help those in need. And I wish you the wisdom not to forgo the love of family and friends in some relentless pursuit of professional or material success. The class of 2021 leaves here with our admiration and our affection. We enjoyed teaching you, we enjoyed learning from you, and we hope that you maintain your ties to your classmates and your alma mater. From this day forward, your accomplishments will always be the most important driver of the reputation of Vincent Massey Secondary School. On behalf of the administration and staff, I extend to each of you our heartiest congratulations and our warmest wishes for success and happiness. Thank you.
Good evening, staff, parents, and most importantly, to the class of 2021. It's an honor to be selected as this year's valedictorian. Now, most people around me, teachers and students alike, know that I love talking. So when I got an opportunity to talk for an extended period of time, uninterrupted, I knew I had to take advantage of it. So let me not waste any of your time, and let me take you guys back to the year 2017, specifically November the 22nd. Now, this day might not hold much significance to many of you, but for me, it was the first time I've ever went to an event at Massey. Coming from a grade school and eighth of Massey's current population, I was in awe when I walked into the cafeteria that evening to attend Massey's annual multicultural dinner. Something about the food, the meticulously crafted signs, the music blaring from the speakers, or the overall joyful mood amazed me. There's no place in Windsor on any given night where you can find pizza, pasta, hummus, salsa, and meatballs all on one plate. This is exactly what my older cousins were bragging about before I came to Massey. They told me Massey was a school full of opportunity, a lot of diversity, and they were exactly spot on. On this night in November, I knew that if I wanted to get the most out of the next 4 years of my high school experience, I would have to participate and organize in events like these. Within the walls of this school is where my childhood would reach its climax and where I would meet people that would literally change my life. And that's exactly what I hoped to do. So when my senior year was cut short last year, I had to take a step back. I watched as dreams and opportunities slipped out of my hands, and I prayed that things would go back to normal. Spoiler alert, they didn't. And as things became more and more unprecedented, all of us tried to scramble to find some normality amidst this chaos, and it was hard. Hovering over that join meeting button every single morning was a painful reminder of the things that we've missed out on. This is exactly the opposite of what my older cousins told me high school would be like. And at the time, and even now, high school felt like a 2,000 piece puzzle, only to open the box and find 1,000 pieces in it. Sure, take your time, grab those 1,000 pieces and make some sort of picture out of it. At the end of the day, you'll never be able to piece together the entire puzzle and see the full picture. So when you lose something, or when something goes missing, you tend to panic. And that's exactly what I did. I scrambled and tried to find some sort of memory, some sort of good moment from my senior year that I can use to remember, use to tell my kids. But there's nothing. And while writing the speech, I took a breather and assessed my situation. Logically speaking, when you lose something, you have to assess what you have left, what you still have. And that's what I did. I realized that I still had memories from before quarantine, before March of 2020, that I still hold close to my heart. So what were the memories that made me smile and laugh every single day? What were the memories that got me out of bed every single morning to go to school? It took me a little bit, but I recalled a few. Maybe it was all those times after school doing homework with friends in the cafeteria, but we'll usually just be fooling around. Or maybe it was all those after-school clubs and activities where I forged friendships that could potentially last a lifetime. Or maybe it was walking down the halls every single morning saying hi to all the teachers and friends that passed. Or, most likely, it was all the food I stole during lunch. And, wow, thank you for all the food. Now, all these moments got a laugh out of me. These moments mean so much to me. And because of quarantine, it gave me a newfound perspective on what high school really was to me. It took all these small and at the time insignificant moments and turned them into things that I would miss dearly now. And I won't lie to anyone watching today. I would love to see a crowded front rotunda at 306 one last time. I would love to watch an entire cafeteria of students write a math contest silently for 4 hours straight one last time. And especially, I would love to walk to Tim's with friends at lunch one last time. It's rather bittersweet thinking about these moments now, but at the end of the day, if there's anything quarantine taught me, is that to never ever take these moments for granted ever again. I have to give gratitude to the people who made these memories possible. To the parents, thank you for being kind, supportive, and understanding of us teenagers during these difficult times. To the teachers here at Massey, you guys strive to create a comfortable online experience for many of us, and we thank you for that. As per reputation, each and every teacher try to get the best out of their students and create an environment of academic excellence, and I am proud to say that I am a graduate from Vincent Massey Secondary School. I could make a whole speech praising all the teachers I've had over the years, but sadly, I'm on a time limit. Administration, thank you for making all the tough decisions and keeping things organized during a very hectic year. I will not lie again. The class of 2021 was one very problematic group of students, so thank you for dealing with our chaos since 2017. To the maintenance staff, your job this year was the most important. To keep things sanitary and safe during these times of COVID, we appreciate your efforts. I'll speak on the behalf of the entire class of 2021 when I say thank you. The staff here at Massey have created a positive impact on every single one of our lives, and I wish for all the best for them as they watch us, the kids that they've been taking care of for the last 4 years, move on into adulthood. And finally, most importantly, the class of 2021. It's an honor to graduate with such a talented group of students. The peers around me have never failed to inspire me and create the person that I am today. Without the peers around me, I never would have watched Attack on Titan, never would have realized how bad I am at basketball, and I would not be standing behind this podium tonight. I've shared many personal experiences with many of you. I've cried, cheered, fell in love, laughed, screamed, and yelled, all while around you. I've met some of the most smartest students, the most cheerful students, and most importantly, the nicest students on the entire planet. As these 4 years progressed, we grew together, we matured together, and most importantly, we persevered together. 2021 was a year of challenges, and as they were thrown at us, as the world gave us trials that they didn't think we would overcome, here we are, standing strong, and I want you guys to know that this speech signifies the light at the end of the tunnel. I want you, the one watching right now, to know that whatever challenges you may face next, you can face with experience and expertise. Sure, we might have faced a lot of failures and defeats this year, but we will not let those bring us down. Visionary artist Big Sean once said, "Last night took an L, but tonight we bounce back." And that's exactly what we're going to do. He was not wrong. Starting tonight, I want you guys to bounce back. I want to create new memories, new experiences, and make up for the time that we have lost. I want to show the world our spirit, our excellence, and party harder than we've ever had before. So join me in ushering a new era of joy, and let's all have an absolutely legendary summer. Vincent Massey Secondary School, class of 2021. My name is Stephen Fung, and it's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Something we can write? No, we're doing the video. Nah.
Going out tonight changes into something red. Her mother doesn't like that kind of dress. Everything she never had, she's showing off. Driving too fast, moon is breaking through her hair. She's heading for something that she won't forget. Having no regrets is all that she really wants. Chasing it tonight, doubts are running round her head. He's waiting, hides behind a cigarette. Heart is beating loud, but she doesn't want it to stop. Moving too fast, moon is lighting up her skin. She's falling, doesn't even know it yet.
Having no regrets,
that's all that she really wants. We're only getting older, baby. And I've been thinking about it lately. Does it ever drive you crazy? Something red. Her mother doesn't like that kind of dress. Reminds her of the missing piece of innocence she loves. We're only getting older, baby. And I've been thinking about it lately. Does it ever drive you crazy? Just how fast the night changes. Everything that you've ever
you don't know what you got. turn your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
Honor to conclude the graduation ceremony for Vincent Massey Secondary School, class of 2021. A heartfelt congratulations to all the graduates and their families. We recognize that a virtual graduation was not the ceremony that you wanted, and it is not what we wanted here at Massey either, but it is the best that we could do under our current circumstances. You may not have been walking across the stage tonight to receive your diploma or throwing your caps in the air as a group, but you are still graduating together as the class of 2021. What started out as a two-week shutdown to flatten the curve has ended up being 1 year, 3 months, and 13 days of challenges and changes that have interrupted your normal high school experiences. My father used to say that normal was just a setting on the washing machine, and these last 470 days of COVID-19 has proven his point, as there have been very little normal in these past 15 months. This is the beginning of your story, and you have all worked so hard navigating high school in a pandemic. You are a part of history, and you can push forward and see the future that you wish to create. On behalf of administration, I would like to thank the people who put together this video and organized our virtual ceremony this evening. All of this work was done outside of your regular classroom duties, and we appreciate it so much. We also wish to thank all the staff here at Massey. Hard work and dedication in the classroom, both in person and virtually, as well as the extracurricular activities after school and on weekends. Thank you for your commitment to our school. Events beyond our control have forced us all to pivot, change our learning models, and you have continued to push forward and persevere. I would also like to send out a special thank you to the parents, the guardians, and the extended family members of our students. You trusted us with your children. You nurtured and supported them at home, and you have worked with us over these past 4 years. Be proud, because you have raised wonderful adults. They are high school graduates with their whole lives ahead of them. Finally, to the class of 2021, I have had the privilege of spending the last 3 years with you here at Massey. We have watched you learn, grow, and mature. You have supported each other through a pandemic, when your bedroom became your classroom and you moved to virtual learning. I hope that these last 4 years have been some of the best years of your lives, because your futures are bright and there are so many more opportunities and pages to add to your stories. Go out and help create an inclusive community. Share your gifts and talents with the world. Celebrate your accomplishments, and above all, be kind. Congratulations to the class of 2021, and best of luck with your future endeavors. That's all for today, Massey. Have a marvelous Monday.